Welcome to MCI TV, Miss Carcom International. I'm your host, Monica Sanchez, and today our guest is Hollywood actor, Mr. Danny Glover. We're really glad that you took some time out of your busy schedule to visit with us today. You know, we know that you're an ambassador for UNICEF, and you do a lot of things with the kids worldwide.
Children represent an extraordinary number of the population. You know, you take a country like Senegal, West Africa, and some places where children from the ages children up to the age of 19 represent more than 50% of the population. That's huge. So the question becomes, in the process of nurturing children and the changing demographics of where people live, where they reside, they now, majority of human beings reside in urban areas, because we all know that women and children are the center and the lifeblood of the communities, and how integral that is to a child's development, growth, and how he sees himself and identity as well. So those are the kind of things that have always pushed me. One of the opportunities I had was to work in the UN family. And it seems like I always wanted to work in the UN family, even when I was a young kid, you know, say 12, 13 years old, because I thought the idea of the United Nations was an extraordinary way of looking at our relationships, not simply just on a nation-to-nation basis, within the nation, and within our own experience, but to understand the parallels and understand the integration of relationships on an international level.
Well, you certainly are the image of what a UN, an international person, because you travel so much and you've covered so much area of the continent with your work, dealing with from heads of state to, like you say, families, because we know how important families are. And you go to the core of it, which are the children.
I'm a father. I'm a grandfather.
You are.
You know, and all that. And you understand the importance of structure and family.
Even in New York City, mm-hmm. in the school system, you have so much emphasis now. It seems to be a strong movement to reconnect the family with the children and put a little bit of emphasis on the child.
Education, children, and everything else. You have to fixate them and place them within the context in which they live and operate on each day. If you're not doing that, then we don't understand what the problem is. So the problem is, it's much larger than we want to admit, because if we admit to what the real problem is, we would want to have some sort of transformation of the system that we live in. A system that is, as Dr. King would say, it's not a more people-orientated system than a thing-orientated system.
So Danny, tell us a little bit about your mom.
Well, you know, I talk about my dad a lot. I talk a great deal about my dad, but I tell you, my friend, Carl Lumley, described my mother as a force of nature. But I think all mothers and all women are force of nature. But I tell you, she has quite some woman, man. You know,
I heard she was a little lady.
She was she had the most enormous presence. She was a big woman. Mm-hmm. She was tall. I get my height from my mother's side of the family. You know, but she was a doer, and when I said doer, she had enormous leadership skills, organic leadership skills, and I think that was most separate her. She was the regional president of the National Council of Negro Women.
Wow.
She knew Dr. Dorothy Height very well. You know, my mother was born in 1920.
Wow.
So, soon my mother was born. She'd be 94 years old. She was alive this October. Wow. And that was the kind of moral underpinning of that. Because you know how important that is. So she graduated from college in 1942.
Wow.
Graduated from a small college, taught a year of high school. And then came up to New York, where she met my father, who was stationed in upstate New York during World War II.
What a history.
They went on a date. Their first date was to go see Adam Clayton Powell Jr. speak. That was the first date, and then it went dancing.
So it's in your blood, Danny.
Huh? and my father was the kind of guy, because he was like 5'5". He was the kind of guy that he'd have friends, but he'd always, the people my father always found himself in a conversation with, Jimmy, let's go down and see Adam Clayton Powell speech. He said, Adam Clayton Powell? I said, let's go and see. And he would always bring something back from that, you know, and all that sense. Because he just had a high school education, my dad.
Wow.
And so he had gone there, and the guy, he'd always have friends. He'd have friends who were college. His best friend was about his. I met him at the time he was in. They were stationed together. They were both same height. They were small men. And so they went to see Adam Clayton Powell, and they just happened to go by his friend's cousin's house, and two women walk in,
and one was my mom,
and the other one said, I'll take the small one. He said, my dad said, I want the tall one.
He was a brand guy.
He said, that's all right, I want the tall one.
What would you say in the educational system and what's going on right here at home in America, especially New York, what is your views on how do we reconnect the child with the family? How do we get that?
One, we have a large number of dropouts and children who don't finish school, children who are basically illiterate. And at the same time, you say, okay, why this is happening? Society still functions to some degree. And the question is, around education, is that how do we rethink education?
Thank you so much, Mr. Glover, for taking time out of your busy schedule to visit with us today. We do appreciate you. And we hope to see you on the show again sometime. We wish you well with all your endeavors. And to our audience, thank you so much for being with us today. This is Monica Sanchez from MCI TV saying so long.